I'm going to share with you some of the flaws of the 401k and IRA. Number one flaw is it requires far more money to be saved than the average person can save. I mean, you look at the number, you look at the disposable income, most people simply can't save anywhere near the money they're going to need for the 401k or IRA to really be a retirement solution. So my point is this, is that when we talk about those human issues, those human challenges, to create a plan that only services a small percentage of the population is no plan at all to me. Over the last 35 years, since you mentioned the 401k or the IRA, the American scene with retirement and financial security has gotten worse and worse and worse, which to me indicates that these plans are a complete failure. Next flaw, you can't access the money until you're 59 and a half without a severe penalty. It's your money. You lose your job, you have a severe medical problem, and then the government is going to hit you with a 10% penalty. Plus, you pull the money out, then you got to pay your income tax on it all at one shot. Next is it does not provide any alternative income. Here's what I mean by that and why this is so important. When do you want to start getting financial help?
When you need it.
How about as soon as possible? How about today? Not 59 and a half. How about let's start giving, you know, let's put a plan together that's going to start helping me now. It's going to start creating income for me now. It's going to lighten my load now. That can continue to grow so when I hit 59 and a half, maybe I can retire even sooner. It doesn't allow any of that. It is zero help today, and if you need help today, it's going to kick you in the teeth. And then upon withdrawal, all that, you know, supposed tax advantage, they hit you with the full freight when you start pulling the money out. So the actual benefit of it becomes really, really minor.